Reading, writing, and arithmetic are the cornerstones of a good education. But that knowledge is well supported by concepts of global citizenship and social justice. Here now to tell us how Chesapeake Bay Academy students and teachers are approaching those subjects is upper school teacher Synnika Lofton. Welcome back to the Hampton Roads Show.
Thank you. It's always a pleasure to be here.
So, how do social justice issues in writing, how do they go together?
They go together in a really unique way. A lot of my poetry and writing students have been studying writers for many years now. And so they've studied writers like George Orwell, who talked about exposing totalitarian governments in, say, Animal Farm. They've looked at Nadine Gordimer, who's talked about apartheid in a lot of her writing. And so students can easily connect with a creative source, which writing provides, and it allows them to kind of talk about the issues that may or may not mean something to them.
Right, and why is social justice, why is that topic so important to be teaching the kids?
Yeah, because in our day and age, there are a lot of issues that affect a lot of different people, lack of resources, inequalities, maybe in education or healthcare. And so we're really teaching our students to really get involved and be active participants in their communities as well as, around the globe.
And when we talk about social justice, how do you define that? What does that include?
It's difficult because, it depends on the individual, and we're talking everything from racial discrimination to, like I said, healthcare inequality and things of that nature. And a lot of them for the school, inside of schools right now, they're going off into college, and so they're dealing with possibly, student loan debts, and will the degree actually, further their ambitions. And so we're really trying to get them involved in their communities because after, the adults nowadays leave, it's going to be up to them to provide solutions, for their problems.
Right. So is this something that you ask the students to kind of define for themselves?
Yeah, I present, a bunch of different social justice issues that are happening out. You never really want to direct them to one particular thing. We want to, inspire them to connect with something. Once they connect with something, then they're more able to really talk about it and really dig into it, for their own personal growth.
Right. So if this sounds interesting to students, how do they get involved?
Yeah, there's a number of ways to get involved. I mean, especially in their own communities, there's fundraisers, there's donating time at libraries and recreation centers and senior citizens' homes and homeless shelters and things they can do around their schools, promoting diversity, not just of race and culture, but of opinion and ability and things of that nature. So there are tons of ways for students to get involved.
Right, and it sounds like maybe they can find some issues maybe that are close to their hearts,
sure,
that they feel passionate about.
Sure.
Is there an age where you can start, where they can really start to get it, or can it be as young as?
Yeah, I mean, you can definitely start with really young populations and help them grow and foster an understanding of what social justice means and how it's developed. And as they get older, you kind of adapt, different types of events and activities so they can kind of see what's out there and what's there to explore so they identify with something.
All right, so keep that as part of the education
as
well.
Keep part of the education.
All right, Chesapeake Bay Academy, you can get involved and experience it by having your child spend the day at CBA at their upcoming Shadow Day. That's Tuesday, November 4th. To find out more or to RSVP, contact Dana Callow at dcallow@cba-va.org or call 497-6200. You can also visit them online at cba-va.org. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.